Well, just got on the expressway, headed to the scissor gig. I got, let's see, 10.2 miles to go. 15 minutes. My doodad thing tells me. All right, stand by. This is the area where they eat breakfast at. They have the meeting and all the quilts and stuff is above us in another building. Same building, but this is the basketball court for the church. I got to move my table down about 3 foot, you know, my carpet. My mat, you know what it is. I haven't got any scissors yet, but I'm setting up. But I do have two knives already. How about that? And I see a $10 bill sneaking out of the bag here. Look at that, look at that. 10 smackers. I always carry my Dremel and all my little doodads sometimes I run into with these scissors. Never know what you're going to find. Some of them bring you little teeny scissors, some bring big scissors. Now this is the best of it. Breakfast cereal. Yogurt, I presume.
See what she looked like when we got her?
Oh, that's pumpkin and chocolate chip.
Oh, yeah.
Zucchini, lemon and poppy seed, banana, walnut, and honey.
I got one of these and one of these. And one of those.
The two later.
And
it was rubbing all her. I have an English Springer and a Springer.
And oatmeal. Mmm. Good place to be. This is my shopping thing. I didn't know I was going to get any knives today. Usually just get scissors. And I brought belts only enough for 600 grit and no leather. So I'll shop them out on this, which I only had two. And I may not get any more. We'll have to see how it goes. I have no scissors yet. Getting ready to open now at 9. It's I don't even know what time it is. 9:07. That's why the place is empty almost. They're moving upstairs. I use, of course, my veil, which has a scissor attachment right there. This arm slides into that attachment, and this arm moves back and forth, you know, like a regular scissor attachment on twice as sharp or anything else. The only modification I've done to it, I had my buddy Jim Imons in Kansas City, Missouri, who has a big sharpening company called Ace Sharpening, and he's a machinist as well. He made me this little adapter right here. It sits on top of the veil stud, that way I can use my clamp for the twice as sharp. The clamp that comes with the veil is adequate, but the one that comes with the twice as sharp, this is the wide model. I make a narrow version too, but it's got an ergonomics handle on it. It's a nice clamp for scissors. Sits right in there, just like downtown at the races. You tighten right up with that ergonomics handle. All we need now is some scissors. In my bag of knickknacks, I forgot I had my ceramic rod in there. My fine, I got my medium and my fine in there. I can hit those blades on this and give them a little bit of shine too. The lady just told me she's going to get me some scissors right now. Cool. Well, I got the first few. There's two pair in there. A little teeny pair and a big pair. And a 10. There's two tens in there. What's two tens in there for? Maybe there's more in here than I know about. There's one on two. Oh, three. She needs $5 worth of change. I think we'll just charge her $10 and be done with it. In here, there are two. In here, there are two. In here, there is one. And in there, there are two. So let's get going. Well, here's the second wave. There must be one pair there. I don't know. They're bringing them to me left and right, though. Same place they had last year. Oh, I get a cookie too. Cookie, yep, and a ham sandwich. Well, I'm done for a while. So the next wave comes in. Last year, I don't think I remember doing many after 1 o'clock. And they even got a pickle in here. Good gracious. Jason's out there, it's okay. They put mustard in the package, mayonnaise. Fine looking ham sandwich. Tomatoes and mayonnaise and lettuce. Jason, I like it. They supplied the table for this event, which I didn't know they were going to do. That's like a 9-foot table, maybe. I brought mine, not knowing they were going to supply one. That's the longest table, and it's not a fold-up. That's the same rig I used at Williams and Sonoma, my igloo cooler. I got my veil bolted to it. I'm going to sit right there. So it's low, you know, it worked perfect sitting down. Inside that igloo cooler is a 20-pound bag of sand that I use for my tent weights. When I'm windy days, I hook it on my tent. I just use it to stabilize that cooler. I take it out and put most of this junk in that cooler on my way home. And the bag is just sitting in the back of my truck. All right, we got a lull in the action. Everybody's just waiting and getting their sandwiches. It's a shade before noon. Let's go see what it looks like outside. Yeah, it's a beautiful day. It's cold though, it's in the 40s. A lot of quilters here, I can tell you that. This is the side entrance to the big church. The church is, of course, over to the left. It's a big church. Look at the kitchen. It's bigger than most restaurants that you go in. Freezers and fryers and, good gracious, refrigerators. Amazing. Well, sometimes it takes a while for my light to come on. I'm so used to seeing a 6-foot table that I work on at home. I'm thinking that's long, so I said 9 feet, but it's the same length as the gun show tables. It's 8 foot, because my carpet, what do you call it? Painter's cloth is 9 foot long. And you can see there's about some inches on both sides of it. So that's an 8-foot table. They got round, most of them are round in here. Except for the ones that they got the displays on. These are grant prizes that you buy tickets for, you know. That's a fancy sewing machine right there. I bet that thing's got a hefty price tag on it too. A Smarter by PFAFE, it looks like. Tickets are $5 for that baby. Probably computerized. What else we got in here today? I don't know what's going on over there. They've been there all day, them two ladies. Well, let's see how many scissors we've done today. No credit cards. Every bag has a $5 bill in it for one pair of scissors, $10 for two, you know, $15 for three. So we got that's four pair, six pair, eight pair, 10 pair, 12 pair, 14 pair, 16 pair, 18 pair, 20 pair, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29 pair we've done today so far. That's better than a stick in the eye. What I want to know, how do you sharpen scissors on the belt? You sharpen them on the belt the same way you sharpen them on a twice as sharp. The stone wheel goes down, the belt goes down. You clamp the scissors in the twice as sharp jig. You take a magic marker and you mark the angle of the scissor. And then you file that angle away. I didn't mean the magic marker. You have to set the angle with this gauge right here. We set it 50 degrees up to 0 degrees, minus five. Most everybody I know sets the scissor in the jig. Puts the scissor up to the belt, trying to find the angle by sight and guess. After a while, you get pretty good at guessing. Then you take the belt and you turn it by hand to see if you're taking the marker off. And if you're not, you have to make another adjustment. We weren't even close. Stand by. I think these are going to be 25 degree scissors. I made a quick pass by hand. Let's take another pass and take a look. With the variable speed motor, you see, it's just creeping along. You can actually just make it just barely creep along. You see how slow it's going? You can see that arrow. You just stick this baby in there. They can even stop the belt if you're not careful. See, look. And you can see most of the marker's gone right there. So we're in the right spot. These happen to be 25 degrees on both sides. Of the 29 pair today, I would say 50% of them were like 5 and 10 degrees on one side and knife blade on the other, 50 to 60 degrees. They're all gone. I don't think I have any of them to show you. Let me see what's left of this bag. Well, maybe I do. Let's see. Nope, they're about tens. What's in this bag here? No, they're 30s. I think all the knife blade ones are gone. Yeah. If I get another pair, I'll show you. But anyway, you just put it up here. You have to take alcohol and get the magic marker off. Just like a large salt machine with a stone on it. I'm using a 150 grit belt, turning it slow. You don't get any heat, no buildup, you get a nice burr. I may be done. Everybody's coming in now to get their sandwiches. She's going to make an announcement and see if there's anybody got any scissors left. If not, I'm headed to the Rancho Max. Post haste. I just talked to Timmy. He said it was cold at the market outside where he was today. I knew it would be, though. Blowing like it is, and only like in the 40s. That wind, you know what it does. He said, I think he said he did 12 or 13 knives and 3 or 4 pair of scissors. So he got gas money and spending money and tipping money. A gathering of quilters. There's a big quilt. I guess it's the Ladies of the Quilters Guild. Somebody made it up. But I'm only guessing. It doesn't have any descriptive signs or markers or to tell you what it is. I think she's blowed up. Can you see the smoke coming out of her? Cheap ass Harbor Freight thing I bought 3 or 4 years ago. I ain't used it but 4 times, 5 times maybe, in that length of time. My buddy in Gary, in Texas, gave me this Gary. He gave me this hot tip on these grinding wheels to work on them lawnmower blades with. Well, it worked fine cleaning this one up in an initial edge. But the cleanup is wonderful. So I started on one of the new Hondas. I got about 5 passes on it to get the paint off and maybe put an initial edge on it. He says he sharpened the lawnmower blades good. You see, this one I haven't done, but my fine little ticket is give up on me, it looks like. Stinks like hell. Piece of junk. I mean, not this. I just bought this thing right here. I'm talking about this thing. Drillmaster. That's a nice thing that is. God. Back to the belts. Okay. 20 Lichter machinery. $25. I can put all my toys on my buffer now. You remember that fancy buffer I made? This rare jewel right over here. I put the variable speed motor on it. Well, I never used it. I took the motor off of that. I think I told you this already. And put it on this Kalamazoo. So now I got a variable speed Kalamazoo and a variable speed Vail. But I had no motor for that. So I saw a guy on the internet put 2 of these on both ends of his buffer. I can put my gray clone 3M wheel on here. I can put my Sisal wheel on here. I can put my pink wheel on here. And put my wire wheel on here. All I gotta do is loosen this up, slide a new one in. I like it. That's right. Make a little noise there, Gladys. Oh, Gladys. I'm thinking about doing the same thing on this end, so I can put different wheels on there, buffing wheels. I've had this for 2 years. It bolts onto the shaft like that. I'm gonna try it. But I'm out of the I'm out of these little doohickeys. I bought these from Granger. Half inch wheel augers. They just got a quarter inch shaft on them, and everything, it slides right into that drill thing, that chuck. Now this baby right here was really thick, and on a whim, I bought one of these from somebody else. I can't remember who. Oh, I bought it from, Super Grit. I bought it from Super Grit. And it's wide enough that this thick wheel will fit on there. But I need about two or three more of these jobs right here. I think they're $8 and something a piece. I think Granger had them for. I have to order some. I like it. Okay, I'm done for today. I'm going to close up the books and go inside. Watch the golf.